Hi everyone, it's Casey Williams. Well, if you look behind me and you're seeing the outline of what you know is a Toyota Prius, you may or may not be excited about that. But here, let me tell you the truth about it. This isn't just your typical Prius. This is the Plug-in Prime Edition. And beyond being a plug-in, which is pretty cool, and I'll tell you about that in a minute, it's actually a pretty decent vehicle inside of it. So let's go have a look. Well, driving the Prius around this week, people could tell there was just something just a little bit different with it. And if you're not a big Prius fan or aficionado of Priuses, you can tell it's just something, again, just a little bit more aggressive. If you can say that a Prius has a more aggressive look to it. But I kind of like the way it looks. You have the quad LED headlamps right here, LED driving lamps, LED fog lamps down below. And the front's all redesigned. Again, just gives it just a little more sporty look to it, I guess, a little more futuristic look to it as well. But when you come around the side of it, there's no mistaking what this thing is. It's an iconic shape and it's clearly a Prius. But the design really is to improve aerodynamics, make it a little more efficient. And that works out really well. Some of the side detailing, I think this looks really good. Kind of gives it a tail fin look. And you come around the back again, the Prius Prime just has a different look to it. Kind of the double look here in the back. The glass does the same thing. Just gives it more of almost like a back car appearance. Again, you either like it or you don't, but I think it's kind of cool for what the car is. Come inside. And one of the really nice things about the Prius, again, you've got the hatchback, seats fold down, quite a bit of storage space back here. But when you lift up this little cover, this is where the plug's kept. And I want to show you real quick what you have to do to plug the car in. Unfortunately, we don't have a charging station here, which is where this would go. But where you think it's the gas cap, actually the plug, there's actually a gas cap on the other side of the car. Because there, you plug it in, clicks into place. If we're plugged in, there's actually a light here. It tells you it's green, tells you you're plugged in, and you're good to go. So to charge the vehicle takes about 5.5 hours on household current, about 2.5 hours, a little less than 2.5 hours on a 240 volt charger. Well, as has become pretty obvious, right, there's two parts to the powertrain of the Prius Prime. There's the plug-in system, and that goes with electric motors and a lithium-ion battery pack that's housed in the center of the car. Up front, though, is a 1.8 liter gasoline four-cylinder engine. Combined system outputs 121 horsepower. So in a car this size, that's enough power, and it's got a continuously variable transmission. Whatever you think of that. So it's enough power for what it is. But what the real benefit of this is, it's fuel economy and driving range. So after you plug it in, you can drive 25 miles on electricity, after which the gas engine will come on, and you've got about 640 total miles of driving range. That's pretty impressive. So fuel economy in hybrid mode, when you've got the gas engine and you're using electricity all at the same time, you're looking at about 55 miles per gallon in the city, 53 miles per gallon on the highway. And as is typical with hybrids, you get a little bit better fuel economy in the city because you're just able to stay in that hybrid mode and electric mode more often. In electric mode, 133 miles per gallon equivalent. So a pretty efficient car for what this is. Well, you know you're inside of a Prius, but it's also a little bit different in the Prius Prime. And it really does start, you know, with the center screen. They try to give a little bit of a Tesla look to it. I'm not sure if this doesn't really work as well as a Tesla does or even some of the others, but I think it gives a really cool look. It's easy to gain access to everything you need. You know, press on it, climate control comes up, audio there, navigation as well. This has a JBL audio system in, so it sounds a little bit better as well. But, you know, you start to realize that this is a plug-in vehicle and you start looking at some of the other options here. Go to the menu. We can look at energy usage. This is kind of cool. Engine just started back up. So it's showing you the engine came on, it's replenishing the batteries, it's powering the things inside the car. You can check your past driving record. If you're a hypermiler and you want to really play a game and make sure you're getting the best mileage, you can do that, and this kind of helps you track that for you. Charge schedule. Again, you can charge this off peak, you can do it from your phone, you can get an app to do this from your telephone. So you can charge a car, you can monitor on your way, you can monitor the battery on your way. That's kind of cool if you're really into checking that. So again, I think this works out pretty well. It's pretty easy. But the rest of it is pretty typical Prius. This one's really well loaded. So we've got heated leather seats, you've got a heated steering wheel, which is really nice. And it's got all the crash avoidance systems on it. You've got the forward crash mitigation system with pedestrian detection. You've got lane keep assist. You've got the rear cross path detection, rear view camera, blind spot warnings. So pretty much a full 360 degree safety suite. But the one thing I want to show you that you really are going to notice different about this car, these three buttons right here. And this is really what separates the Prime from the other Priuses. You can go through the drive modes and it shows you up above. And this is really just for the throttle sensitivity. So you're in power mode, just makes it a little spunkier when you step on it. Normal, that's kind of the middle level, and then echo. Again, you really have to mash the pedal to get the car to move, but that's really what it's designed to do, is to discourage you from using gasoline. So I kind of liked it in normal mode. That was kind of fun most of the time. Next to that's a button. So it can be in full hybrid mode. And again, I've been driving around all day, so the battery's depleted right now, and it's telling me that. But you can put it in just regular hybrid mode, kind of like a regular Prius, or if you press that button again, it goes into EV mode, and it's a dedicated electric vehicle for the 25 miles. Or if you exceed 84 miles per hour, the gas engine will come back on. And then there's an EV auto mode, and that will just let the car kind of make its own decisions about whether it's EV, it's hybrid, or some balance of the both. And typically what will happen is, you know, if you hit the throttle hard or if you drive faster, it'll use gas more often. So if you really want to be in EV mode, you really want that 25 mile range without the gas engine running, put it there. But the other nice thing about the electric mode is, you know, when you're on the highway and you're really, you know, burning a lot of energy, you really don't want it in electric vehicle mode at that point in time. So just put an EV auto, put it in hybrid mode is probably best for that. But it's just a really cool car. I mean, I think it's driving around, it's certainly a futuristic feeling. And it's, you know, very practical. You've got the phone charging pad here in the middle, inductive charging, lots of storage, and it's just a very, very comfortable Kia car. There's a broad range of electric cars. You can have, you know, a full gasoline engine, you can have a hybrid, as has been the typical Prius in the past. You can have a full electric car like a Tesla that, you know, you're pushing 300 miles range or more in some cases. Or you can have a car like this, I think balances this pretty well. And there are a lot of vehicles in the market now that kind of have that 25, 30 mile all electric range, plus a gas engine. So you can drive back and forth to work every day for most people on electricity, plug it in at home, plug it in if you've got a charging station at work. But you still have plenty of driving range. So, you know, again, 25 miles all electric in this vehicle, 640 miles total with the gas engine and the gas tank fully filled. So a good balance. And the real advantage of being able to do that is the price point. So this car starts at $27,100. As it's equipped right now, $33,985. Again, fully loaded leather interior, heated seats, heated steering wheel, audio system, everything upgraded. So I think that's a pretty good balance for this car. Well, next week we'll have another fun car, and until then, storm forward.